Motown's sensational teenage supergroup. Here come the Jackson 5. You're not going to tell me you pick your own costumes. You must have a costume designer or something.
Yes, we have a lady by the name of Ruthie West who designed all of our costumes, you know.
Well, don't let her go. No. Did she look at you and say, you're going to be shocking pink, Michael's going to be blue, Jermaine's going to be darker blue,
sometimes,
and you're the purple passion, huh?
Yeah.
Who got all their hair pulled out in Europe? I heard about that.
Oh, yeah.
That was Mike.
Was it you, Mike, they got?
Well, it really was all of us. Like, you know, we went to London, was the first one we went to. And we arrived at the airport. There were thousands of kids sleeping in, you know, packing bags. And
sleeping bags.
They were just waiting for us. And when we arrived, there were a lot of people there. And they just went wild. They were grabbing us. And so all the guards and the police, they made a long line so we can walk through. when we walked through it, all everybody just caved in on us. And I had on a tie, and they were choking me this way and that way. And I lost my shoe. And
that'll get the voice higher and higher.
Yeah.
Well, somewhere in England, there's a little lady walking around with handfuls of hair, right? She might be making a lot of money on that, Michael.
Well, everybody had some hair.
Where'd you go for? Where'd you play in London, Albert Hall?
Well, we played the Wembley Stadium. And we were the first ones ever to break the record there. We broke the Beatles record.
Well, I don't doubt it for a minute. I mean, they're the most entertaining group. It just, it really swamps you to see you fellas in performance. And tonight you open at the MGM Grand Hotel.
First time, yeah.
Not the first time in Las Vegas, though.
First time
in Las Vegas.
Oh, okay. Let me tell you about that town. Now, we better get the gospel songs out. It's a very sinful city. Don't leave your rooms, okay?
Okay.
Oh, you're going to love it there. That's so nice. What, after you left London, where'd you go?
We went to Paris, then we went to Amsterdam.
Germany.
In Germany, then we went
back to London.
Yeah, then we went over to Australia, then Japan,
New Zealand,
and our last trip was Africa. It was great.
Where in Africa did you play?
Dakar, Senegal.
How many turned out?
How many? 100,000.
Gee.
Played a stadium.
100,000 people at $1 a head. You don't need another brother, do you? Jackson, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, who are you?
Well, you
didn't wander in and just join this crowd, did you?
No, first time I haven't played on stage was here. We played Hell's Poppins, my first television show.
Oh, yay, that was that big show they did on this stage here.
Yeah.
They hit each other in the head with...
Yeah.
Pies
and
chickens and yeah.
Yeah, and then from then, you know, I started traveling all over with them.
I mean, you were an immediate hit on that show, and the brothers said, "Let's put him with us."
Yeah.
Right. And you play the drums.
Congas.
Congas.
Oh, Randy, what did you say about the oatmeal boxes?
The oatmeal boxes. How
you
started?
First started playing congas.
Well,
you played a tune on your breakfast cereal?
Right.
Is it close?
Right.
Yeah.
Very
close.
Yeah.
But like when they first started singing, you know, they were singing a long time ago. And I didn't have nothing to do. You know, so I just sat up and watched them. So I got, you know, the Quaker oatmeal boxes.
Oh yeah, the round ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I put them all together with a stick and I started beating them. So I waited a while, and my father asked me, was I ready? So I wasn't ready. In about another year, he said, you can
would you like to come and play oatmeal? How do you get from oatmeal boxes to conga drums, though?
Well, my father bought a set of conga drums, you know.
That's good.
That's what I started.
Are there more at home like you?
Yeah, we have...
Others waiting in the wings to...
we have three sisters. It's 9 kids all together.
We have a large family.
Yeah.
Do they sing? Do they play?
I'd like to mention the fact that my whole family is going to be doing Baker's. My little sister, Janice, she's 7. She's going to do a solo with Randy. They're going to be singing together some of the Sonny and Cher great songs. And my sister, Toya, is going to be tap dancing with us. It's going to be really great.
It's going to be a regular Mormon Tabernacle Choir. Right? I think that's wonderful.
Don't you do your show in Vegas sometime?
Yep, Caesar's Palace.
Yeah.
We're going there in about... we go there the end of April into May.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's all I saw you.
They're the greatest audiences for a nightclub in the world. But you're used to 100,000. I mean, this must seem like a combo to you.
Yeah, we went up there to see Paul Anka's show, and it was really great. It was fantastic.
Yeah, he's a really nice guy.
I can't tell which, except for Michael and Randy, I can't tell. You all look the same age. Who's the old man?
I am.
Yeah. But one is married. Well, that's Jermaine. You're married.
Two married.
Are there two married?
Yeah.
Well, then Jermaine is. I know Jermaine's married.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
He married the boss's daughter. The doo doo doo. You married Barry Gordy's daughter.
Yeah.
Barry. Watch this. Say it 3 times fast. Barry Gordy's
daughter.
Barry Gordy. Yeah, but say Barry Gordy's. Barry Gordy's daughter. Say it 3 times fast.
Barry Gordy's daughter. Barry Gordy's. I can't.
Yes. Yeah, don't laugh at my mistakes. Then one other is married. Is it you, Randy?
No.
No.
I'm married.
Are you married?
Yes.
Are there children yet?
Yeah, I have one son. I've been married 2 years now. I have a 6-month-old son.
You've made this crowd a bunch of uncles?
Yeah. Well, I have a sister who's 24, and we've been uncles 3 years now.
No, it's nothing new.
Are you more protected here with security than you are? Well, I suppose in Europe you're more protected, aren't you?
Oh, yes, a lot of security.
Do the police travel with you?
Sure.
Yeah, like we have security on the floors. Like girls always sneak up. They don't come through the elevator because they know, like, there are police waiting on them. So they go through the stairs.
Yeah, that. But it's nice to. Makes him itch.
Yeah. Is it?
But it's nice when maybe one or two break through and you get to shake hands.
Oh, well, after the show, we'll let them all come upstairs and sign and have a little party for them. And sign autographs.
But not all.
We go to bed every night at 11 o'clock.
Perfect. Do you?
Right. Yeah, we have to be in bed at 11.
11:30.
Even the married guys?
Yeah, everybody.
Right. Because we do
one-nighters,
and like we have to get up sometime at 8. Sometime the plane leaves at 8, we have to leave the hotel at 7, so... Then we have to get rest before the show, so we have to get up early.
Is it ever, though, that the work seems like it's too much?
Well, if you like it, it's not too much.
That's
really
right.
Like it.
I'm enjoyable.
Right. How old are you now, Michael?
14.
So you've grown up right in front of us.
Yeah.
Are you going to keep getting taller and taller?
I don't know.
The first time we did our show was here, too. We did the Diana Ross special here on the Hollywood.
It was Diana Ross who discovered you, wasn't it?
Right. Sure.
A mayor brought you to her...
Yeah, no, it all started in Gary, Indiana.
Gary, Indiana. Wasn't it the mayor who brought you?
Yeah, we were planning for a benefit show in Gary, Indiana, and Diana Ross was the mayor's guest, and we entertained for the mayor at the show, and after we entertained, she came backstage and said we were very, very good. She had to take us to Motown, and we entertained for Berry Gordy and executive staff there, and after that, our first record we put out was a $2 million seller, and after that, everything started going well for us.
I don't know Berry Gordy, but he really must be a genius, isn't he?
He's very nice.
I mean, look at the superstars he's made, and he knows how to publicize an act, and he knows how to make stars out of people. That's extraordinary.
He's really smart.
Do you sit around and decide what you're going to sing, or is it all done for you?
Well, we all get together, us and the producers, and missing the fact we have a 24-track recording studio at home, and that's what we
24 track?
Yeah, we do our own stuff at home now, at our house.
Isn't that terrific? Do you ever rent it out? I think I ought to do a commercial because this audience is... They're all breathing together. They're so excited about hearing you sing again. And I am, too. We'll be back after this word. And the Jackson 5 will be... From Motown. Good-looking one, too. From the album you already heard, It's Too Late. Now they're going to sing for you Dancing Machine, which also has been taken from the album and happens to be their new single. And they're terrific. Let's hear it for the Jackson 5.
She has a dancing machine.
Oh, babe, move it, baby. Automatic, systematic, full of color, self-contained. Tuned and channeled to your vibes. Captivating, stimulating, she's sexy, sexy lady. Filled with space, safe design.
She's moving, she's grooving. Dancing until the music stops now. Yeah.